Gamecock fans. It's the Carolina CrowLine. And here's your host, Tyler Garrett.
We may not be LSU or Alabama, but we ain't Clemson.
11 wins is for every Gamecock always.
All right, welcome into the Carolina CrowLine. Happy New Year to Gamecock Nation. I am your host, Tyler Garrett. Glad to be with you on this football wrap-up edition of the program. We are wall-to-wall football here as we put a bow on the 2012-2013 football season. Gamecocks go out in style with a big-time victory in the Outback Bowl of the Michigan Wolverines. We're going to hear a little bit of Steve Spurrier post-game, say goodbye to some seniors, and talk about who's next to fill those roles. We're going to take a look ahead to the 2013 schedule, some strengths and weaknesses going into next season, and we're going to have your complete BCS championship game preview, all that and more, your emails and tweets. So stick with us right here on the Carolina CrowLine.
At TurboTax, we know your paycheck is more than a number.
It's being there for my customers.
It's lending a hand at any hour.
And it's having my coworkers' backs day or night.
You work hard to earn your money, and we're here to help you keep more of it. TurboTax has experts available to answer your questions by phone or live chat, so you get the answers you need and every penny you deserve. TurboTax, the power to keep what's yours. Try it free at TurboTax.com. Live tax help service is subject to availability, restrictions, and change without notice. See TurboTax.com for details.
This is a referral service. Calls will be routed to an independent referral insurance agency.
Do you know the number one cause of bankruptcy? No, it's not losing your job or running up credit card debt. It's not even divorce. It's medical costs. If you and your family don't have health insurance, just one serious illness or accident could be financially devastating. But now there's good news, really good news. A health insurance hotline has been established to provide health insurance for all Americans, even uninsured Americans with pre-existing conditions. Now anyone can get health insurance even if you have a pre-existing medical condition. I repeat, now anyone can get health insurance coverage. Call now for a free no-obligation quote on affordable health plans available to you. Again, this is a free hotline for anyone, even if you have pre-existing conditions. Protect you and your family from sudden unexpected medical costs. Call the free health insurance hotline right now at 1-800-838-5562. That's 1-800-838-5562. Call 1-800-838-5562.
Hate the thought of shopping? All that hassle and can't find what you're looking for anyway? We understand. Retail stores make it difficult. Instead, try www.edistooutdoors.com. Edisto Outdoors features performance apparel and gear engineered for performance, comfort, and style. Edistooutdoors.com. You'll enjoy the shopping and you'll enjoy the products. Great products from people who care.
The Southeastern Conference has established the most outstanding college football tradition in the country. The 14 member institutions have combined for an unprecedented 459 bowl appearances. Key to the success of SEC football is support of the many loyal fans who have helped the conference lead the nation in total attendance for 29 consecutive years. The SEC salutes the more than 6.5 million fans who will attend a game at an SEC stadium this year.
Think where you live means you have to settle for a slow online experience? You don't! That's why we're introducing Exceed from Viasat. Exceed Broadband brings together the highest capacity satellite in the world, state-of-the-art ground equipment, and breakthrough technology to bring you super fast speeds.
Think what you could do with that!
Watch streaming videos, TV shows, and movies with less buffering, share photos faster, enjoy video chats with less jitter, and send and receive files all much faster. Call Exceed Broadband at 800-397-4999 and you get 3 data plans to choose from, all with the same amazingly fast speed. New feature is
Late Night Free Zone.
Exclusive to Exceed. Customers can download as many movies, shows that they want during overnight hours, and it does not count towards their monthly usage. Call now for special offer, 800-397-4999. We think it's time you get the online experience you deserve.
Think fast.
Think Exceed Broadband. 800-397-4999. Dial 800-397-4999 now. That's 800-397-4999. Again, 800-397-4999. Exceed Broadband. Now that's fast. Call 800-397-4999.
Boy, it feels good to be back here on the Carolina Crow Line. We had a couple weeks off to celebrate the holidays, but now we are ready to jump back into the Crow Line and talk to Gamecock Nation about all things Gamecock news, notes, sports, most notably the amazing come-from-behind back-and-forth victory, 33-28. South Carolina pulls it out down there in Tampa in the Outback Bowl over the Michigan Wolverines, the winningest college football program in the history of the sport. What a thrilling way to finish the season. The Gamecocks back-to-back 11-win seasons for the first time in the program's history. We've said it before here on the Crow Line. This is the golden age of South Carolina football. No time before this has it been better than what it is right now. There is no doubt about that, and the one man that is responsible for the golden era of Gamecock football is none other than SOS himself, the HBC, Steve Spurrier. No matter what you want to call him, he has single-handedly been responsible for the awakening of this program, because you can't really call it a revival because we have never been to these sorts of heights before. So this is an awakening. This is not a revival. This is new territory for the Gamecocks, sure to finish in the top 10 for two seasons in a row. I would venture to guess we'll be in the top 10 to begin the year next year. And just despite the loss of Marcus Lattimore, despite the in-and-out status of Connor Shaw, just the amazing things that, you know, this team has been able to pull off and keep themselves together, rally around their leaders, and still continue to push forward with a big-time victory over Clemson, back-to-back bowl victories here for 2 years in a row. I don't think that's ever happened. Steve Spurrier is now responsible for half of South Carolina's total bowl wins in its entire program history. I believe that's three now with Steve Spurrier when you take a look at the victory over Houston, the victory last year over Nebraska, and the victory just a few short days ago over Brady Hoke and the mighty Michigan Wolverines. South Carolina came out and jumped all over the Wolverines early with the interception, with that long pass down to Demir Byrd for the touchdown. However, the latter parts of the second quarter, as well as the third quarter, and much of the first half of the fourth quarter, all go to Michigan. They had all of the momentum. They had South Carolina right where they wanted them. South Carolina, if you watch that game, I think it is completely fair to say, was back on their heels defensively. However, one man, number 7, Jadeveon Clowney, was single-handedly responsible for turning this game around, stopping the momentum of the Michigan Wolverines. And even though Michigan, I believe, still scored after that hit, drove down the field there with just a few minutes remaining, definitely putting South Carolina's back against the wall. Performance offensively, I think, that outshined the defense. I think when you ask your average college football fan about South Carolina, I think they would mention the defense first, talk to you about guys like Devin Taylor, Jadeveon Clowney. That's probably about it. They would definitely know the name of Marcus Lattimore. However, he hasn't been a factor here for weeks now. But it was South Carolina's offense in the end, averaging over 30 points for the first time in Steve Spurrier's tenure here at the University of South Carolina. In a season, they were able to do what they had to do, to just a wonderful example of perfect clock management down there at the end on that final drive. Connor Shaw re-aggravates that ankle injury on a scramble play, has to come out of the game, and what can you say about Dylan Thompson? Just that gunslinger mentality. You can tell he has that era of confidence. He's a guy who never seems to really get caught up in the moment, really keeps his head on him, focuses, and I can guarantee you this, when he drops back to pass, he is not the type of guy that is going to dance around back there and try to figure out where to go with the football. A la Connor Shaw a little bit. That's been one of the knocks on him, Connor Shaw, this year, of course, was that he cannot drop back, make his reads down the field, and then make a decision and fire the ball in there. He's been more of that kind of guy who wants to run around, and against defenses like a Florida and LSU, we definitely saw, and that could pose a big-time problem. But Dylan Thompson, what can you say? Just, ice in the veins, I guess. The Iceman, Dylan Thompson from Boiling Springs, steps in a big-time situation in Clemson and nails the game, comes in the clutch there at the end of the game for South Carolina, and certainly was able to deliver, able to get out of bounds on that scramble play to stop the clock, and was able to put his team in a position just wide open, Bruce Ellington down the middle of the field. I was amazed that you know, they took that shot. I was waiting for them to – you had to take at least one shot to try and get it in the end zone. You were definitely angling for a last-second field goal to win the game, but you know Steve Spurrier and the kind of guy he is. He definitely wanted to make sure that he was going to put his offense in an opportunity. He's not going to pass up a shot into the end zone to try and get all the glory and nail that game. When you take a look at the stats a little bit, South Carolina with 14 in the first, 7 in the second, and was ice cold in the third and most of the fourth quarter with a missed Adam Yates field goal. You had that Connor Shaw long run down into the red zone, but then that kick, I believe, ends up getting blocked. And then South Carolina, however, was able to manage 2 touchdowns there late in the fourth quarter to bring them back. 33-28 was the final score. I don't know if you were fortunate enough to go down to Tampa and enjoy the Outback Bowl, but I tell you what, the weather, was beautiful. A lot of Carolina fans, a lot of Michigan fans. I thought actually there were slightly more South Carolina fans down there, in my opinion, than Michigan fans, but just Michigan brought the noise. They brought the flashy program. Denard Robinson, you know, a Heisman Trophy candidate, breaking quarterback passing and rushing records for college football. Obviously, he's a senior, so he wanted to go out on top. Denard Robinson, a guy, you know what, to be perfectly honest, I don't know why they didn't give it to Denard Robinson almost every other play. It just seemed like those sweeps and those tosses where the offensive line would just break their stance and head towards the sideline. South Carolina did not have an answer for that. They bottled him up occasionally, but I think for the most part, that was an easy 5 or 6 yards every single time they wanted to run that play. So I was a little shocked that Michigan didn't come back to that play over and over again. And what can you say about Jeremy Gallen and Devin Gardner? They lit up the South Carolina secondary over and over again. Akeem Auguste, Victor Hampton, Jimmy Legree just got victimized, especially in the second half, over and over and over. South Carolina did not seem to have an answer for those guys, but pull out with the win here in the end. On the other side of this short break, you're going to hear a little bit of Steve Spurrier postgame. 803-450-0086, a number to call to get in here on the Carolina Crow Line. Stick with us.
Pride and ambition and Gamecock traditions, yeah. We're all one big family. Carolina, sweet Carolina. Yeah, I'm proud of where I'm from.
All right, welcome back into the Carolina Crow Line. I'm your host, Tyler Garrett. We are back after a short layoff. Merry Christmas to you guys. I hope you had a wonderful New Year, especially if you were able to make it down to Tampa. I actually was able to stay down in St. Petersburg with some dear friends of mine that I went to college with here at South Carolina. And let me tell you what, it was just off the chain. Beautiful weather. Got to spend some time on the boat out there down in Treasure Island, St. Pete area. A little bit chilly on the 30th, but the 31st was amazing. Got some chance to spend some time out at the beach and then had an amazing New Year's Eve out there in Tampa, and then was able to pull myself together in time to get out there and do some tailgating. Really enjoyed myself out there. Raymond James Stadium, a very nice stadium. Boy, I tell you what, they do it right. Big, huge, wide concourses. Actually, really good food. The pirate ship, the whole kind of outdoor open-air concourse. A really neat little stadium to go to. Not super huge, but was able to go down on the field and spend some time down there. It's just a really wonderful experience. I hope you guys had a great time out there, too. I tell you one other person that had a great time out there, and that was Coach Steve Spurrier getting his first Outback Bowl victory. So I'm going to toss it out to the head ball coach to hear his post-game comments after that 33-28 Outback Bowl victory. Here's the coach.
Yeah, wonderful day for the Gamecocks, all of us, to get another 11-win season back-to-back. Gosh, the 2 years have been very similar. 6-2 in conference play, 11-2 overall. Our seniors, can't say enough about those guys. DJ Swearinger and Shaq Wilson, our two defensive captains, Justice Cunningham, TJ Johnson, the offensive guys, and a lot of juniors provided leadership also. But they've really sort of showed our young guys how to play football, how to hang in there, keep playing in the fourth quarter. We've sort of taken some pretty good pride about winning the fourth quarter. And most of our games this year came down to the fourth quarter. And somebody make a play, Jadeveon Clowney's play, knocking that ball loose after the questionable first down call. I told somebody, I'm glad that ref did that now. Yeah, so you never know, because the next play, Jadeveon knocked it loose and we got it and scored to ace the next play. But yeah, a lot of guys played super today. Ace Sanders, the most valuable player in the game, 3 touchdowns, and the punt return, I mean, he was sensational. He's down here in Bradenton, and you probably wonder how we got him away from Florida and Florida State. They passed on him, say he's too little, but he can play football, that's for sure. So that was our good fortune that that happened, but he is an excellent player. And then, of course, Bruce Ellington made the play there at the end. I don't know if I've ever given two quarterbacks a game ball, but today I said, heck, we got to give them both you guys, Dylan and Connor, and game balls to all the seniors. Just cap the careers that they've had here at South Carolina with 38 wins, I think it is now. 9.5 average for those guys. But again, good win for us in the fact that we, you know, scored in the last 3 minutes there. We haven't won one like that since I've been here in 8 years. So hopefully that will sort of tell us, hey, we can do that. It's possible. Just hang in there. Connor made a heck of a play getting out of a sack, and then Dylan got out of a potential sack. And then that last play, they sort of gambled and rushed 5 guys, but he took his steps and let it go, and Bruce was there. It was just sort of, you know, if nobody's down there, throw it. And he threw it down there, and Bruce ran right into it. So it was a good day. Fans here was tremendous. Our Gamecock people were here, and it's good for them to hang in there. And I keep being reminded by a lot of my buddies that we used to leave at halftime if it was going south on us, but we don't leave anymore. So that's encouraging. But again, Outback Bowl did everything first class, super. First Outback Bowl I've ever won. Sort of personally, a little greedy. I wanted to win one. And so I got one on my resume now, Jimmy. I've won an Outback Bowl. Yeah. I've been lucky to win most of these in Florida, but this is the first one of the Outback Bowls. So anyway, any questions? His foot was bothering him. He sort of hobbled off, and Dylan was right there on call, and we obviously no hesitation to fire him in there. Yeah, both those young men are just so super team-oriented. There's no jealousies, nothing. And even though Connor went in there, Dylan went in and zipped us right down the field. You know, he knew Connor was coming back in, and then Connor was okay when Dylan went back in. So that's those guys are just really, really good teammates, wonderful team players.
Steve, have you ever had to put in a quarterback,
last second drive? I don't think I have, and I guess I haven't had a whole lot of them. It's been very successful, to tell you the truth. Haven't been in a lot of those kind of games. Most of our games in South Carolina, we hang in there and get a little bit of a lead, and then tack on a touchdown and win by 10 points. That's been sort of the way we've won most of our games. But today, Michigan probably outplayed us overall. Gosh, they had 82 plays to our 52. We had a lot of big plays. We had more yards than them in just 30 less plays, I think it was. But, yeah, we made some big plays, but we left some out there, too. We had a couple of drives, didn't get anything, missed two field goals. Their guy, I think, made all their field goals. So it was a game that they probably played a little bit better overall, but we were able to score points, score five touchdowns. Well, we're just all out there playing and coaching and seeing what happens. That's all we're doing. And they made a wonderful drive to go ahead there and hit the touchdown to go up by one. You know, I was sitting over there thinking, at one time, I thought they may kick a field goal if they didn't hit that third down play and then kick off to us and see if they could stop us and kick a field goal to win it. But.
All right, so there's a little bit of Coach Steve Spurrier there and his post-game comments. But absolutely, Steve Spurrier, you know, you heard it right there, and he mentioned it. Michigan, you know, I think you cannot disagree with the fact that Michigan definitely outplayed the Gamecocks. I mean, Lord have mercy, Michigan was able to run, I think, 82 plays to USC's 53 plays. The defense was out there for a long, long time. Michigan, and I even turned to someone that I was watching the game with and said that Michigan is just going to 6 yards us to death because we could not stop them, it seems like, almost never for a big-time loss. Now, we all know about Jadeveon Clowney and the couple of big-time tackles for loss that he had, but overall, they had him bottled up occasionally. Overall, though, I think Michigan did an outstanding job rushing the ball. Only 3.1 yards per rush, but they rushed the ball 45 times for 186 yards. You know, lost 45 yards in sacks and tackles for loss. But overall, Michigan did a masterful job trying to keep South Carolina guessing, rushing the ball. And they effectively mixed in the pass. You know, again, when you have 82 plays, you're going to have a lot of opportunities to do both. But I thought Devin Gardner did an amazing job throwing the football when he had an opportunity. You know, Devin Gardner was, 18 for 36 for 214 yards and 3 touchdowns. It was only sacked 3 times. Denard Robinson did not have a pass, but he rushed 23 times for 106 yards. Devin Gardner also added 51 yards, on his own. So, Jeremy Gallen, I would say the Michigan player of the game, 9 catches for 145 yards and 2 touchdowns. It seemed like every time they threw the ball, Jeremy Gallen was wide open in the middle of the field. I know South Carolina mixed in a little bit of man and a little bit of zone, but it just seemed like no matter what South Carolina tried to do on defense, Michigan was able to exploit it on some way. And Jadeveon Clowney definitely makes up for a lot in pass protection. I tell you what, if it wasn't for Clowney, Taylor, Quarles, Jaredo getting that consistent pass rush over and over and over again, I think Michigan definitely would have won this game because they were picking us apart with the pass rush that we did have. Of course, we were able to stop them, here and there early in the first half, especially in the second quarter and in the first quarter. But overall, you know, we were fortunate to come out with a victory. We did what we had to do when we needed to do it, and that's how South Carolina was able, you know, pretty much to walk out of Tampa with a victory, riding high here into 2013, and you know, just kind of continue this momentum on into the 2013-2014 season. Stick with us on the other side of this break. A few more stats from the bowl game, and looking forward to 2013 on the Carolina Crow Line.
Ladies, are any of these symptoms familiar? Weight gain, hot flashes, rapid heartbeat, night sweats? How about fatigue, nausea, low energy? Or what about sleeplessness, low libido, and fat storage, especially around the belly area? If you're a woman over 40 experiencing any of these symptoms, you probably have hormonal imbalance. And until you balance your hormones, it'll be practically impossible to get rid of these problems. But you're in luck because Ambrin is the all-natural formula clinically shown to cause sustained weight loss in women over 40 with no big change in lifestyle. Ambrin restores hormonal imbalance in women over 40, so the extra pounds fall away and the other symptoms simply disappear. To receive a complimentary risk-free trial with a free 30-day supply, just be one of the first 50 callers right now at 1-800-510-3558. Free supplies are limited, so be one of the first callers right now at 1-800-510-3558. That's 1-800-510-3558.
Think where you live means you have to settle for a slow online experience? You don't! That's why we're introducing Exceed from Viasat. Exceed Broadband brings together the highest capacity satellite in the world, state-of-the-art ground equipment, and breakthrough technology to bring you super fast speeds. Think what you could do with that! Watch streaming videos, TV shows, and movies with less buffering, share photos faster, enjoy video chats with less jitter, and send and receive files all much faster. Call Exceed Broadband at 800-397-4999 and you get 3 data plans to choose from, all with the same amazingly fast speed. New feature is Late Night Free Zone. Exclusive to Exceed. Customers can download as many movies, shows that they want during overnight hours, and it does not count towards their monthly usage. Call now for special offer, 800-397-4999. We think it's time you get the online experience you deserve. Think fast. Think Exceed Broadband. 800-397-4999. Dial 800-397-4999 now. That's 800-397-4999. Again, 800-397-4999. Exceed Broadband. Now that's fast. Call 800-397-4999.
Blake Austin of South Carolina Farm Bureau is an insurance agent you can count on to meet all your needs. Home, auto, health, life, you name it, Blake's got you covered, and he can save you on your yearly rates. Call him now for a free quote, 803-259-5008. That's 803-259-5008. Or just go to ClemsonSportsTalk.com and click on the Farm Bureau logo to be connected to Blake. Do like I do and work with the best agent around, and you can tweet that.
All right, we are rolling along here on the Carolina Crow Line. We just wrapped up a little bit of Outback Bowl postgame from Coach T. Spurrier, and you talked about a couple things, or he talked about a couple things that, you know, I forgot to mention. Of course, who can forget the blown fourth down call there in the fourth quarter? Michigan looking like they're going for the punt on fourth down and 4 with 8 minutes and 28 seconds left in the football game. Just a critical point in the ball game, and it just seemed like South Carolina was kind of just going for broke, or Michigan was just going for broke here. And I'll let you listen to the famous, now famous, blown fourth down call.
Hey, Sanders slides back into the shadows of the south end zone. Fake by Michigan. Michigan's running for it left side. They run for the marker. Do they get there? It's very close on the far sideline. A fourth down call for Michigan at their own 37. My goodness, they say they've got it. The second fake special teams play by the Wolverines today. Tommy, what do you see in the glasses?
I can't see, really. There are too many people over there, but it looks like it's obviously close. I don't know. It's right there on the sideline. They still got to bring the chains out, so who knows? Probably got it. The way things are going, probably got it.
Gamecocks with a stop.
No. The official rule.
Says first down.
Yeah, he did.
Boy, the Gamecock sideline went crazy like they held him.
They did. Sure did. And then all of a sudden, he walks up and signaling it for Michigan. So.
Boy, that's a tough place to call it, right there on the Gamecock sideline, too. Spurrier not happy, but he's going to talk to the official. Let's go down to Lakes. Let's see, we're going to call here. What's he want, Tommy? Official review. He wants official review. Spurrier's asked for a review of the spot. Hey,
All right, so you hear the call right there with Todd Ellis. You know, just an amazing turn of events. Clearly, if you were watching on television, and I was in the stadium, I didn't even realize what was going on because I was on, of course, the South Carolina sideline. Could not see really what was going on because of all the commotion and all the bodies that were around the spot of the ball, and, of course, they definitely didn't show it on the big screen. So I didn't really know until I started receiving some text messages and until I definitely got home later after the game was over and saw what happened there. A blown call. There is no mistake about it. No matter how you look, you've seen the YouTube videos of the little girl talking about it on screen as it's paused there in her dad's living room. Just complete and utter referee fourth down fail on that play, if you ask me. And as soon as Michigan, again, even after that, fourth down call. Very next play, handoff to the running back. Jadeveon Clowney annihilates him, able to go down and score and then exchange some touchdowns. And then it all came down to the end. 17 seconds left. Dylan Thompson is in the game because Connor Shaw has had to leave because of a foot injury. It is second and 10. South Carolina has only one timeout left. South Carolina is on their own 32-yard line trying to get into the red zone to angle for a field goal, and then we have the pass.
The wind seems to be okay. Just got to get it up. He's had one block and missed one today. So
what about a quarterback draw here? Thompson out of the shotgun. Throws down. Middle of the field. End zone. Caught.
Touchdown.
Bruce Ellington. Dylan Thompson comes off the bench with 11 seconds to go and gets six. And the Gamecocks are up on the Wolverines. 33-28 from 32 yards out. Oh, my. Hurt me.
What a throw nice. By Dylan and a read by Dylan Thompson, but just a really a bad play by those safeties, Todd, and the linebacker let him get really bad play. And, gosh, we'll take advantage of that. No problem whatsoever. Carolina now calls its final timeout to kind of think things over here a little bit. It's 33-28. So, obviously,
you
got to go for two again here. So,
Thompson still celebrated, Tommy, pumping his fist. I can't believe he threw it.
So there you go. Todd Ellis, never a man short of emotion and intensity. Of course, Michigan brought the blitz around the right side of the offensive line. Bruce Ellington just gets released by the linebacker and just runs wide open straight down the field. I'm forced to assume the linebacker was expecting help by the safety down on the inside right down the seam, but it just opens up like the Red Sea for Bruce Ellington. The easiest touchdown he's probably ever going to have. And just like that, South Carolina comes out with the victory, 33-28. Again, just some final stats on the game. Connor Shaw, was 10 rushes, 102 yards. Kenny Miles only had 5 rushes for 6 yards. You kind of would have liked to have seen a better final game for Kenny Miles than that. Connor Shaw, 18 of 26, 224 yards, 2 touchdowns. Dylan Thompson, only 7 of 10, 117 yards, and 2 touchdowns, which combines for 4 touchdowns and a total of 341 yards. Of course, Ace Sanders was your Outback Bowl MVP of the game. He was able to rack up 9 catches for 92 yards, 2 touchdowns through the air, and also ran a touchdown back. Ace Sanders, I just can't say enough about that kid. Just every time he touches the ball, you expect good things to happen. Kenny Miles was your second leading receiver, 4 catches for 22. Nicky Jones had an amazing catch and run down towards the red zone, 3 catches for 78 yards. Of course, Demir Byrd, that long bomb, 2 catches for 63 yards. Bruce Ellington, 2 catches for 36 yards and a touchdown. Sean Carson actually played in this game. Not very active, though. Didn't have rushing statistics, but caught 2 passes for 1 yard. Rory Anderson, a big-time catch there towards the end of the game. 1 catch for 7 yards. Again, Ace Sanders also had that big fourth down reception to keep the drive going. Adam Yates, not so good from the field goal. Kiss, who's a senior and really, I think, has NFL potential, has an NFL leg, but just continues to need to kind of work on the the accuracy, I guess. But overall, what can you say about that kind of performance? Connor Shaw has since had surgery on that foot, and Steve Spurrier has announced officially will be out for all of spring practice. So you are going to see Dylan Thompson can get all the first-team reps. There's a kid here who's redshirting now. His name is Brandon Nosevich, a kid from Pennsylvania who broke all the high school passing records up there. He's a kid that's going to see increased reps. Connor Mitch is a kid that's now, I believe, is an early enrollee here at the University of South Carolina, a kid out of the Raleigh, North Carolina area, a four-star quarterback. He's going to be able to get a lot of reps because you have Seth Strickland, Andrew Clifford leaving the program. So you're going to have four scholarship quarterbacks minus one in Shaw. You're going to have a big-time spring for a lot of those quarterbacks to start to get a lot of reps, start to get that practice, start to get used to the playbook. Nosevich is a big kid who can run, who's got some mobility to him. I know that the coaches are very excited about his ability and what he could potentially bring to the table. So over and all, 11-2 again on the season, two very disappointing losses to Auburn and Florida. They're back-to-back in that tough month of October, but you got to be happy. No SEC title shot, but you do overall, I think, if you're a Gamecock fan, have to feel very comfortable with what we were able to accomplish here in 2013. Again, just to throw a few more statistics at you, overall for the season, Connor Shaw attempted 228 passes, completed 154 for just a shade under 2,000 yards, 1956. 17 touchdowns, 7 interceptions for a passer rating of 158. Dylan Thompson, interestingly enough, only completed 66 passes, which is 52%, but had over 1,000 yards passing, 10 touchdowns, 2 interceptions to Connor Shaw's 17-7, and a slightly lower passer rating at 142. Overall total rushing, Marcus Lattimore led the way, 143 rushing yards for 662 yards, 11 touchdowns. Connor Shaw, 435 yards rushing. I believe he had 7 rushing touchdowns last year, but only 3 rushing touchdowns this year. I guarantee you that was kind of twofold. Number one, the coaches were looking at for him to go ahead and become a more effective passer, and with the lack of mobility that Connor Shaw was forced to experience due to injury during the Vanderbilt game, the shoulder injury, and then the foot injuries later on down the year, I think definitely cut down on that. Kenny Miles ends his career with 100 attempts at 359 yards and 2 touchdowns on the season. Mike Davis, 275 yards on the season, a kid who's really going to be counted on next year to kind of step up and start to pick up that slack along with Brandon Wilds and Sean Carson. Ace Sanders was your leading receiver on the season, 45 receptions for 531 yards, 9 touchdowns. Bruce Ellington right behind him, actually more yardage than Ace, 600 total yards and 7 touchdowns. Lattimore, your third leading receiver, 173 yards. And then Justice Cunningham, your senior tight end, is on the board as well with 324 yards. Stick with us right here on the Carolina Crowline as we say goodbye to the seniors for the class of 2013. All right, we're rolling along here on the Carolina Crow Line. I'm your host, Tyler Garrett. 803-450-0086 is a number to call to get on the Crow Line. Of course, we are streaming our broadcast live on www.spreecast.com right now. You can tune in usually Sunday or Monday evenings here to the program and watch us live. Of course, if we're not available in your local radio market, please email the show and ask us to get in touch with the people in your area and demand the Carolina Crow Line be put on the radio waves where you happen to live across the great state of South Carolina. You can always email us, carolina@y'all.com, carolina@y'all.com, or you can follow us on Twitter or like us on Facebook. You can also, if that's not enough for you, go on to iTunes and you can get a free podcast edition of the show. Always, you can go back and get all the season's podcasts. Of course, you can also go to YouTube.com and look at all of our past broadcasts for your viewing pleasure as well if you happen to miss the Crow Line for any unknown reason. I can't imagine why you would. But in case you do, it is available in a multitude. Yes, that's right. I said it. A multitude of ways. We're going to go ahead right now and kind of wrap up the Outback Bowl talk, but I just want to go ahead and recognize the senior class here at the University of South Carolina, the all-time winningest senior class here at the University of South Carolina. You know, a group of seniors that kind of is a mix of 2007, 2008, depending on if you redshirted or not. But, you know, a big senior class, mostly on the defensive side of the ball. I'm just kind of going to go down by positions and just read to you the seniors that will be missing, and I'm going to let you know a little bit of who I think is going to step into those roles to make sure the South Carolina continues to experience success down the road. Of course, we're going to say goodbye to Seth Strickland as well as Andrew Clifford. Those are going to be two guys that are going to be leaving the program there at quarterback. Running back, of course, we say goodbye to Marcus Lattimore and Kenny Miles, a senior who's leaving the program. Quay Gilchrist, the fullback, will also be leaving the program. D.L. Moore, as we found out before the bowl game, is your lone wide receiver that will be graduating here at the University of South Carolina. Of course, was ruled ineligible for the bowl game, so that effectively ended his career. Of course, Justice Cunningham, the big-time senior tight end, is going to be leaving the program, a kid that I think has really developed as he's been here at the University of South Carolina, and I look for him to get on with an NFL team somewhere down the line. He just does everything well. He's a solid player and just doesn't do the kind of bonehead things that occasionally some players do. Seniors, T.J. Johnson, of course, the center, pretty much started from almost day one here that he stepped on campus. We're also going to say goodbye to senior Caleb Broom. Defensive tackle Byron Gerardo, of course, will be leaving the program as a senior. He's a former junior college transfer. Of course, this signals the end of the career of Devin Taylor and Aldrick Fordham, two guys that I think were stalwarts there along the defensive line. Definitely Devin Taylor starting with his sophomore year here at the University of South Carolina. Linebacker, we graduate the entire two deep at linebacker. Shaq Wilson, starter Shaq Wilson and Reggie Bowens, but of course, Quinn Smith, as well as DeMario Jeffrey, the backups to Wilson and Bohms, respectively. All those guys are graduating. A lot of holes to fill at the linebacker position, and I'll get to that in just a second. Speaking of linebacker, the spur safety hybrid linebacker position, Devontae Holloman is also a senior. He will be leaving the program. Of course, Jungle Boy Swag, DJ Swearinger, the man in the back of the defense, the unquestioned leader of the defense, in my opinion, at least the vocal leader, the kind of guy that kept everybody together with workouts and practice and film study. DJ Swearinger has played his final game in a Gamecock uniform, will be moving on to the next level. Akeem Auguste will be moving on to the next level. He has spent a lot of time in the South Carolina program, but he finally gets his shot at the next level. Adam Yatesy, the kicker, is a senior as well, and so is long snapper Walker in Abinett. In all, 20 seniors, 11 on the offense, 11 on the defense, 7 on the offense, and 2 on special teams. A big-time class that will be losing, of course, when you add Marcus Lattimore into that mix. And still up in the air, actually, surprisingly enough, Ace Sanders is still weighing his decisions about whether or not he should forego his senior season. Had a big-time year this year for the University of South Carolina. Had a big-time bowl game there down in Tampa. So a guy who's really looking to possibly get out into the NFL while his stock is very high. And of course, I'm sure he's got Marcus Lattimore in the back of his mind as well. We'll have to wait and see what he does. But those are your seniors class, ladies and gentlemen. On the other side of this break, who's going to fill their shoes? You're about to find out right here on the Carolina Crow Line. I don't climb, climb, climb. Boss man can shove that overtime up his can. All I want to do is put a drink in my hand.
Want to hear the sound of hassle-free traveling?
All aboard!
Amtrak takes the hassle out of traveling to over 500 destinations. You can stretch out in a spacious seat, relax in a sleeping car, and enjoy a hot meal in the dining car. And for those who want to kick back and take in the scenery, go right ahead. For everything you get on Amtrak, the one thing you won't get is this. So whether you're going to a family reunion or an away game, make it a whole lot nicer on Amtrak. Book your trip today at Amtrak.com or call 1-800-USA-RAIL.
All aboard!
Hate the thought of shopping? All that hassle and can't find what you're looking for anyway? We understand. Retail stores make it difficult. Instead, try www.edistooutdoors.com. Edisto Outdoors features performance apparel and gear engineered for performance, comfort, and style. Edistooutdoors.com. You'll enjoy the shopping and you'll enjoy the products. Great products from people who care.
At TurboTax, we know your paycheck is more than a number.
It's brown bag lunches every day.
It's picking up extra shifts.
And it's catching the bus to work.
You work hard to earn your money, and we want to help you stretch every dollar. That's why TurboTax lets you file your simple federal return for free. It's free to prepare, print, e-file, and you can even chat with a tax expert. TurboTax, the power to keep what's yours. Get the federal free edition at TurboTax.com. Live tax help service is subject to availability, restrictions, and change without notice. See TurboTax.com for details.
This is a referral service. Calls will be routed to an independent referral insurance agency.
Do you know the number one cause of bankruptcy? No, it's not losing your job or running up credit card debt. It's not even divorce. It's medical costs. If you and your family don't have health insurance, just one serious illness or accident could be financially devastating. But now there's good news, really good news. A health insurance hotline has been established to provide health insurance for all Americans, even uninsured Americans with pre-existing conditions. Now anyone can get health insurance even if you have a pre-existing medical condition. I repeat, now anyone can get health insurance coverage. Call now for a free no-obligation quote on affordable health plans available to you. Again, this is a free hotline for anyone, even if you have pre-existing conditions. Protect you and your family from sudden unexpected medical costs. Call the free health insurance hotline right now at 1-800-838-5562. That's 1-800-838-5562. Call 1-800-838-5562.
Are any of these symptoms familiar? Weight gain, hot flashes, rapid heartbeat, night sweats? How about fatigue, nausea, low libido, and fat storage? If you're a woman over 40 experiencing any of these symptoms, you probably have hormonal imbalance. Ambrin restores hormonal balance in women over 40, so the extra pounds fall away and the other symptoms simply disappear. To receive a complimentary risk-free trial with a free 30-day supply, just be one of the first callers right now at 1-800-921-9020. That's 1-800-921-9020.
All right, welcome back into the Carolina Crow Line. I'm your host, Tyler Garrett, where we talk all things Gamecock. We are wrapping up, kind of putting a bow on the 2012-2013 football season here for the University of South Carolina. Welcome to our final segment of the program. On the front side of that commercial break, we were talking a little bit of the senior class and who we're going to be saying goodbye to. As we wrap up the program, let me just talk about the people that I think are going to be responsible for stepping in and filling in the shoes of those seniors that will be leaving the class to make sure we continue on the upward swing that we have been so fortunate to experience here the last, 4 years here with the Gamecock football program. Of course, Kenny Miles and Marcus Lattimore say goodbye. I think you take a look at three guys that will be splitting the carries next year. Brandon Wilds, we know what he can do as he filled in last year for Marcus Lattimore to the tune of 100-yard rushing performances. You were able to get to see Mike Davis this year, a lot of potential. Sean Carson's a little unknown. We know he's got the speed and the shiftiness. He hasn't really been able to take advantage of it, but he is finally healthy. I expect for him to do a lot of good things going down the line with a full spring practice. So I look for kind of like that three-headed monster, a la an Alabama or a LSU almost, those three guys to really take the bulk of the carries next year. Of course, you have Kendrick Sally, who has not stepped on the football yet, recovering from that knee injury out of Williston Elko. He will be a redshirt freshman next year, ready to contribute as well. So in my opinion, definitely kind of an open competition type of situation there at the running back position. D.L. Moore leaves the program. If Ace Sanders decides to stay, I'm sure D'Angelo Smith, Ace Sanders, Bruce Ellington, Demir Bird, Nick Jones, Shaq Rowland, maybe even Shamir Jeffrey might jump up and surprise somebody. A logjam at wide receiver with everybody fighting for time. We'll see who's able to step up there. A lot of people really excited about Shaq Rowland coming off his freshman season. Of course, Justin Cunningham, if I could spit it out, is leaving the program. That slot belongs to Busta Anderson, of course, with Jarrell Adams, I think, joining the fold. Everybody likes the talent that he brings to the table. An absolutely huge target there at the tight end position. And Drew Owens is going to look to claw for some playing time. TJ Johnson, the center, of course, is leaving the program. He's a guy that I think that's going to be Cody Waldrop. Was a redshirt freshman this year. He's going to be a kid. Kyle Harris is transferring out. He was going to be the next in line there at the center position. It's not working out for him. So Cody Waldrop out of Florida should be the guy that you expect to see at the center position next year when we open up in 2013 here in Columbia against the North Carolina Tar Heels. Jardo is a senior. Quarles, of course, occupies one side of that defensive tackle position. I expect Dixon Jr., Deion Green to challenge for that spot. Dixon Jr., a kid who saw a lot of playing time this year, and Phillip Dukes, a highly touted defensive tackle out of Manning, South Carolina, hasn't spent a ton of time on the field, but he's coming around. The coaches like his talent and ability, and I expect him to fight for that starting position. So I would either say Dixon Jr., Gerald Dixon Jr., or Phillip Dukes is going to occupy that defensive tackle position. But who's going to take Devin Taylor's position? I think you look none other than Chaz Sutton, a very athletic guy, a guy who came in with the rabbit package when you had four defensive ends on the field. You had Fordham, Taylor, Clowney, and Sutton there on the field. Sutton is going to be the guy that 98% likely going to occupy Devin Taylor's former spot. So Chaz Sutton, a guy that used formerly committed to the University of Florida, now is going to be his shot to play opposite to Davion Clowney in what will be undoubtedly his last year next year as well. Linebacker is a very dicey subject. Everybody's graduating. You've got Cedric Cooper, who just went down with a torn ACL in bowl practice. Those things take anywhere from 9 months to a year, so it looks like he's going to be out. You've got a true freshman, Kawan Lewis, a linebacker from New Jersey, and you also have TJ Holloman, a linebacker out of Georgia, who looks like he's going to be manning those two linebacker positions, as well as possibly true freshman Lorenz Bryant, the number one outside linebacker in all of the nation, is committed to the Gamecocks currently, also out of Vance, North Carolina. So he's going to be coming down. The coaches love his talent. It looked like he's going to get some playing time as a true freshman. You got to think that the linebacking core is going to be a definite weak spot and concern for next year. Devontae Holloman is gone. It looks like Jordan Diggs and Sherrod Golightly are the heir apparents there at spur. Swearinger, of course, is gone at safety. It looks like TJ Gurley, who went down with a knee injury early in the year, is going to be occupying that spot. Possibly Kadetrix Marcus as well. Of course, you've got Bryson Williams occupying the other safety position. Of course, Hampton and Legree will be juniors and seniors next year. Those are going to be your two starting corners. And it looks like Nick St. Germain, or possibly is going to be your starting place kicker and kickoff specialist next year, a kid that was put on scholarship out of Georgia, or possibly Landon Ard, who was a former teammate of Jadeveon Clowney's there at South Point High School, could possibly squeak his way into the rotation here for place-kicking duties. So it's going to look very, very different here for the University of South Carolina next year, definitely on the defensive side of the football. I like the offensive line, a unit that was young this year, I think has gotten a lot of invaluable experience. Brandon Shell, Corey Robinson, A.J. Cann, Ronald Patrick, all those guys. I look for the to actually be a strong point next year. Thank you for listening. I'm Tyler Garrett. This is the Carolina CrowLine. We're going to come back with a little bit of recruiting next weekend, and it's almost baseball time, and the Cox open SEC play with Frank Martin as well. So a lot to talk about next week. Stick with us on the Carolina CrowLine. Go Cox.